Good morning. Since the time of Jesus, Christians all over the world have celebrated the day that Jesus died. We call that Good Friday.
But why would it be called Good Friday if it's the day that Jesus died?
That confuses a lot of people. Jesus did something that day for all of us, something great. He went to the cross so that we could have eternal life, and we celebrate that and call it good.
He showed his love for everybody. He died for you, for me. It was very good.
And so even though that day itself was a horrible day as Jesus went to the cross, we celebrate because ultimately it led to his resurrection.
Jesus suffered and died because of God's vast love for us. He gave up his life for you and for me so that one day we could live with him in heaven. What great news! His way of the cross was a way of love. The fourth grade class and their teachers have continued this tradition of the Stations of the Cross to reflect upon this act of love, to remind you and your family to stay hopeful, and to celebrate the victory of his resurrection.
Today we focus on the last days of Jesus' life, the days when he was betrayed, put on trial, and turned over to be sacrificed for our sins. It was a very dark time for Jesus, a time when he had to rely on his Heavenly Father to see him through the darkness, just as he now sees us through dark times. The 14 stations are 14 ways that Jesus showed his love for us.
Much of Jesus' life was busy and happy. He grew up in a Jewish family and community that was centered around their faith in God.
He went to the temple on holy days. Jesus didn't start his ministry until he was 30 years old. It was during these last 3 years of his life that he preached the gospel, cured many people, and gained a large following of disciples.
He came to a place called Gethsemane, and Jesus told his disciples, "Sit here while I pray."
Feeling very low, Jesus took Peter, James, and John with him and said to them, "The sorrow is so great that it almost crushes me. Stay here and keep watch while I pray."
He went a little further on, threw himself on the ground, and prayed, "Father, all things are possible for you. Take this cup of suffering away from me. However, not my will, but your will be done."
An angel from heaven appeared to him and strengthened him. In great anguish, he prayed more passionately. His sweat was like droplets of blood falling to the ground.
And Jesus returned and found the disciples asleep.
He said to them, "Why are you sleeping? Weren't you able to stay awake even 1 hour? Keep watch and pray that you will not fall into temptation."
Jesus was still speaking with Judas, one of the 12 disciples, arrived.
With him was a crowd armed with swords, sent by chief priests, the teachers of the law, and the elders. The traitor had given the crowd a signal.
Judas then says, "The man I kiss is the one you want. Arrest him and take him away under guard." Judas approached Jesus and said, "Judas, is it with a kiss that you will betray the Son of Man?"
When the disciples saw what was going to happen, they asked, "Shall we use our swords, Lord?"
Jesus responded, "Enough of this. Must you come with your swords and clubs to arrest me? This is the time to act, when the power of darkness rules."
The first station, Jesus is condemned to death. At daybreak, Jesus was brought to the house where the high priest, elders, and the teachers of law were meeting.
They stood up in front of them all and questioned Jesus. "We have heard him say, 'I will tear down the temple that men have built and rebuild it in 3 days.' Not even the high priest could make their stories agree."
"Have you no answer to make? Are you Christ, the Son of the Blessed?" the chief priest said to Jesus. Jesus answered, "So you say that I am. You will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of God."
"Blasphemy," exclaimed the chief priest. "You need no more witnesses." Then the chief priest bound and led Jesus to Pilate.
Pilate turned to Jesus and asked him, "Are you the King of the Jews?"
Jesus replied, "You have said so." "Have you no answer to the charges set against you?" Pilate asked. But Jesus kept quiet and didn't say a word.
Pilate turned to the people, saying, "Then what shall I do with the man you call the King of the Jews?" The crowd yelled, "Crucify him! Crucify him!"
Pontius Pilate told Jesus he was going to be crucified even though he was innocent. Jesus didn't say anything.
Sometimes people accuse us of things we haven't done. How do you feel at such a time? How do you think Jesus felt? What was in his heart?
The second station. Jesus takes his cross. The Roman soldiers bring a large wooden cross for Jesus to carry. It is very heavy and rough.
For Jesus, the cross stands for all the world's evil, cruelty, and hatred. Jesus, by his love, transforms this cross into a symbol of hope and salvation for us. When you make the sign of the cross on your body, remember this cross which Jesus carried out of love.
The soldiers placed a purple rope around him and a crown of thorns on his head. They began to salute and mock him. They then gave Jesus the heavy cross to carry and led him out to be crucified. Though Jesus is tired, sick, and weak, he reaches out and accepts the cross lovingly.
The third station. Jesus falls the first time soon after he begins to carry the cross. Jesus falls. He's exhausted and the weight of the cross crushes him.
Even our blessed Lord fell under the heavy cross he was carrying. He had no one to help him. Christ always wants to help us when we fall.
When you have difficult things to bear, think of Jesus. He falls under the burden of the cross, so you shouldn't be surprised if you fall. When you are able to get up and go on, you are like Jesus.
The fourth station. Jesus meets his mother on a narrow roadway. Jesus turns the corner and looks ahead to see his mother. She reaches out to touch him. He is thankful she is there.
She does not say anything to him, but he knows that she still loves him and is proud of him, even though she feels sad and helpless. Sometimes we don't want our mothers to see us in trouble. And yet, we feel comforted when they appear and tell us they still love us.
Fifth station, Simon helped Jesus carry the cross. The soldiers could see that Jesus was getting tired and staggering under the load.
They pulled a man out of the crowd to help Jesus carry his cross. His name was Simon of Cyrene. He did not know Jesus. If they had pulled you out of the crowd, what would you have done?
The sixth station, Jesus falls the second time. The soldiers let Simon go, and Jesus carries the cross by himself. Jesus stumbles and falls.
By now, Jesus is very tired, and he falls again but rises and goes on. When we weaken and fall, Jesus knows from his own experience how hard our way is. He will be our strength and helper in every difficulty.
The seventh station. Jesus meets weeping women. There are some women standing along the street. They were friends of Jesus. They loved him very much.
Jesus said to them, "Weep for yourselves and for your children." The woman felt sorry for Jesus because he was suffering so much and many of the officials were treating him cruelly.
The eighth station. Jesus falls a third time. By this time, Jesus could hardly walk. He fell a third time.
Jesus felt he could not go on anymore. Again, he struggles to stand up because he's chosen to live the way of the cross.
The ninth station.
station, Jesus is stripped. Jesus, the soldiers, and the people came to Golgotha, the place of the skull. The soldiers stripped Jesus of his clothes and divided them among themselves.
They treated Jesus as a common criminal, as if he were a worthless human being. When you are made to feel embarrassed and treated as if you are without value, know that Jesus understands because he has experienced shame.
The tenth station, Jesus is nailed to the cross. The soldiers nailed Jesus to the cross. Jesus prayed to the Father in heaven, "Forgive them, for they know not what they do."
Someone in the crowd yelled to Jesus, "So you're the one who claimed that he would destroy the temple and in 3 days rebuild it? Why don't you save yourself?"
Another yelled, "Come down off that cross if you're a God's son."
The 11th station. Jesus promised the thief paradise. One of the criminals crucified next to Jesus asked him angrily, "Are you the Messiah? Save yourself and us."
But the other thief does not join the ridicule. He knows he has done wrong. He asks Jesus to remember him in his kingdom. Jesus promises, "Today you will be with me in paradise."
Jesus is innocent, and even in his pain, he welcomes the guilty. We are encouraged to know that no matter what we've done, it is never too late for forgiveness. Jesus still welcomes us into his kingdom.
12th station. Jesus is on the cross. The cross is standing and Jesus is hanging on it.
Time goes by very slowly, for Jesus is full of pain. More important than his pain is his love for us and his willingness to die so we may know peace. Jesus says, "Father, into your hands I commit my spirit."
He bowed his head and gave up his spirit, and we watched the blood run down his broken body, and we began to understand the meaning of the bread and the wine.
We realized that he did not have to go through any of this. God had given him the sins of the world, and he had gone as quietly as a lamb to be sacrificed.
We were watching the greatest act of love the world has ever known.
The 13th station. Jesus is taken down from the cross. The body of Jesus was taken down from the cross.
His mother Mary held him in her arms. Mary remembers holding Jesus when he was a baby. Mary could not hold back her tears.
The 14th station. Jesus is buried. So we buried Jesus. We thought that was the end, but it was only the beginning.